Welcome to video 2 in our QuickBooks security series, putting in usernames and passwords. Usernames and passwords are the foundation of security in QuickBooks. When you first create the file, you're logged in as the administrator, or admin for short. Anyone who uses the file right after it's created is logged in as admin. Admin has access to everything in the file. Once you make an admin password, you cannot open the file without inputting the password. So if you're not going to use security features, it might not be a good idea to make an administrator password, because once you do that, you will always have to put in a password every time you open up the file. It's the administrator who gives all the other users their usernames and their passwords. And it's also the administrator who gives the other users whatever permissions they might have. And we're going to show you, after we put a password on the administrator, we're going to show you how to set up other users with different usernames and passwords and give them permission. But for now, let's just give the administrator the password. When we do this in our example, we'll leave the username as admin. You could change the username to something else, but in our example, we'll keep it simple. When deciding on a password, we will use the conventional wisdom. We will take the typical common advice for setting up a safe password. That means the password will have at least one capital, at least one number, and at least one special character, also considered a punctuation mark. So for this example, I have decided that the admin password will be Jeremy12 with a capital J and an exclamation point after the number 12. Let's take a look at what the file looks like both before and after we put in an administrator password. Here's the file for the Holden Video Company. It does not yet have an administrator password. So now when we double click, QuickBooks will open up the file with no problem at all and without asking us for a username or a password. It opened and it did not ask us for a username and password. Now we want to put a username and password for the administrator. Once we do this, we will never be able to open this file again without putting in some kind of username and password. So make a backup copy before you do it. From the main menu, click Company and go down to Setup, Users, and Password. Come across to the right and down to click Change Your Password. Now, let's leave the username as admin. It's only 5 letters and only the A is capitalized. Now, you will not see that I'm typing it in from PowerPoint. Or I'm not copying in from PowerPoint. I'm going to type shift. I'm going to shut off the cap locks and hold down the shift key and type J. Jeremy12 shift exclamation point. Okay. Now I have to make sure I did it properly. Capital J E R E M Y 12 shift exclamation point. Challenge question. What is the name of your oldest nephew? The answer is Jeremy. So click OK, and now QuickBooks recommends your QuickBooks password has been changed. We recommend you change it again in 90 days. Well, we'll worry about that in 90 days. Click OK, and now you will not be able to open this particular file until you put in that password. Now I'm going to prove it to you. I'm going to close out QuickBooks and give it a moment to, you know, power down. Now this very same file, I'm going to double click and open up. Give it a moment to boot up. And lo and behold, it's demanding a password, and if we don't put it in, we won't get in. Okay? By the way, if you click I forgot my password, you can still recover your password or at least reset it if you type in the security question. But let's just type in the regular password and see what happens. JEREMY12 with shift exclamation point. Click OK. And lo and behold, QuickBooks lets us back into the file. And now that we've made an administrator username and password, we're going to set up another user and give that user a password. After we do that, we'll give an example of how the administrator sets permissions. In this example, the username will be Jill, and again, we will follow the conventional wisdom when making a password, at least one capital, at least one number, and at least one special character or punctuation mark. In this case, it'll be Allison22 with a capital A and a question mark at the end. From the main menu, click Company, Setup Users and Passwords. Now we're going to click Setup Users. Before we do that, we have to make sure we again put in the administrator password. Shift for capital J, E-R-E-M-Y, 12, shift exclamation point. Click OK, and now it allows us to add user. The username will be capital J, lowercase I-L-L, and the password will be shift capital A, L-I-S-O-N-2-2, shift question mark. Let's make sure we did it right. Shift capital A, L-I-S-O-N-2-2, shift question mark. Now, don't worry about the QuickBooks license issue. That's an issue for another video. When we click next, we are asked, do we want to give Jill access to all areas of QuickBooks or just selected areas? Here in our first example, we're going to click all areas of QuickBooks. Then click next, and it says, are you sure, blah, 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 and we're going to click yes. Now, notice it gives you a list of places and things within the file that our new user can do. And you can browse this later to remember what Jill is allowed to do and what Jill is not allowed to do. Click Finish, and now we have the administrator and we have Jill. Now, we could always log out, but I think that the best thing to do is to close this window, and now let's make sure Jill can log in. When we close QuickBooks, do we want to back up? No. Give QuickBooks a few seconds. Now, when we reboot the program by double-clicking our company file, it'll ask us for the password, and instead of admin, shift capital J-I-L-L, and let's make sure we remember Jill's password. Shift capital A-L-I-S-O-N-2-2, shift question mark. Click OK, and lo and behold, we're logged in as Jill and not the administrator. It is very important to remember that even though we did not restrict Jill in any way, it is still the case that only the administrator can add new users, delete existing users, change access privileges for other users, import and export data, change company preferences, change company information like the name and address in the file, set or edit closing dates, create accountant's copy, or clean up the data file. These are all things that only the administrator can do that Jill or any other user cannot do. Now, you remember a moment ago, we allowed Jill to have access to all areas of our QuickBooks file. But even though we told QuickBooks to give her access to everything, Just the fact that she is not the administrator prevents her from being in these nine areas or doing these nine things. Now allow me to prove this to you by giving you two examples of having Jill try to do something and get an error message that she's not allowed to do it. First, let's confirm that we're logged in as Jill. Company, set up users and password, set up users, and you could see Jill is the one that's logged in. So let's close it out, and we know she's not allowed to change company preferences. Click Edit Preferences. Every area of preference has a My Preference tab and a Company Preference tab. The My Preference tab can be changed by any user because that's the preference of a particular user. And QuickBooks will remember each user's My Preference. But look what happens when we try to click Company Preference. Okay, when we go to change something, we'll get this message. Only the QuickBooks administrator or external accountant can perform this action. You must reopen the company file and log in as the admin or external accountant to do this. Now, of course, this video is going to explain what external accountant means, and that's coming up very soon. But that's one example of what Jill is not allowed to do. The other example is change the company information. From the main menu, click Company, and then click My Company. Now, you can see this is where we would normally put the username and password, but we're getting a warning message here, and there's no pencil to click. Normally, there'd be a little pencil to click for us to edit the name and address of the company. But instead, we have this message. Only the QuickBooks administrator or external accountant can view this information. So that proves, as long as we're logged in as Jill and not the administrator, there are these few things that Jill is not allowed to do. Now, let's go even deeper. Let's limit Jill's permissions so that she can handle all area of receivables and customers, and she has access to the vendors and payables transactions, but not the reports. What would we have to do first? Well, first, we have to make sure that we close the file and reopen it and log in as the administrator, because only the administrator has the ability to do that. Okay, capital A, lowercase D-M-I-N, admin. Don't forget the administrator password is capital J, lowercase E-R-E-M-Y, 12, shift, exclamation point. When we click OK, we're logged back into the file, but now we're logged in as the administrator. Now we can click Company, set up users and passwords, set up users. Now again, it's asking for the administrator password, capital J-E-R-E-M-Y, 12, shift, exclamation point. Click OK. And now we're going to edit Jill, and we're going to click Edit User. Now, the username and password is fine. We're not going to change that. Click Next. But this time, we want to give her selected areas of QuickBooks. Click Next, and now it's going to ask us each area one by one. Sales and accounts receivable, we'll leave it as full access. Click Next. Purchases and accounts payable, we'll click selective access, and then we'll put create transactions only, which means she cannot print transactions and she cannot see payable reports. Click Next. Now, for all other areas, we're going to click no access, next, no access, next, no access, next, no access, next, no access, next. Do you want this user to have the ability to change or delete transactions in the areas they have? Yes. Should this user also have the ability to change or delete transactions that were recorded before the closing date? No. And we'll talk more about the closing date later. Click Next. And it gives us a summary of all the areas that Jill does and does not have access to. And you can browse this on your own time. When we click Finish, We now have set the permissions for Jill. Now, let's prove that they work properly. In order to do that, we have to close QuickBooks completely and then reopen QuickBooks and log in as Jill. And we will see if the permissions work. Now, we're not logging in as admin. We're logging in as capital J-I-L-L. And again, it's capital A-L-I-S-O-N 22, shift question mark. That's Jill's username and password. Click OK. And here we are logged in as Jill. Now, let's see what areas we're allowed to use. If we click banking, write a check, up. You need checking and credit card permissions to perform this action. Oh, gee. Let's try the areas that Jill was given permission for. Click customer, create invoice. No problem there. What about this? Customer, enter time, use weekly timesheet. Up, you need time tracking permission to perform this action. And we had told QuickBooks no when it comes to Jill having permission for this area. But what about this? Vendors enter bill. No problem there, because we allow Jill to record transactions in the vendors and payable section. Now let's look at the reports. Reports, customers and receivables, any report we choose, Jill is allowed to see. However, even though Jill was allowed to enter bills and record transactions in the vendor area, when we click reports, vendors and payables, unpaid bills, we get the message. You need reporting permission under purchase and accounts payable to perform this action. Looks like the security features are working pretty well.